Go to wix.com/go/simplehistory to create a website now. What did Henry VIII eat? Tudor feast. Dining for the nobility during the Tudor period was about much more than just food. The size of a household and the quantity and variety of food provided were an important way of demonstrating wealth and influence. It wasn't uncommon for rich Tudor households to spend up to a third of their annual income on food. The majority of this was spent on meat, usually lamb, beef, poultry, pork, fish such as haddock, herring, or cod. Veal, venison, and wild boar were also popular. It's a common misconception that wealthy Tudors didn't eat fruit or vegetables. This is possibly brought about by the fact that the estates would have grown their own produce, and so they don't frequently show up in purchasing records. Despite this, there was a pervasive belief that fresh fruit and uncooked vegetables were unhealthy and carried disease. In the court of Henry VIII, the average courtier could be expected to be served from a daily menu that totaled around 5,000 calories. The vast kitchens at Hampton Court Palace, which Henry had extended, were able to turn out 1,000 meals a day. Food was served twice a day, once at 10 a.m. and again at 4 p.m., with dishes made from the finest ingredients that came from all four corners of the globe. These included sugar from Cyprus, citrus fruits, almonds, and olive oil from the Mediterranean, and spices from as far afield as Africa, China, and India. Fresh, high-quality meat, though, was the most important component of the courtly diet, and included roast game, plenty of meat pies, and even swans and peacocks. Such was the consumption of meat that after one visit, the contemporary political theorist Thomas Starkey was led to proclaim that if they don't have 20 varied meat dishes at dinner and supper, they consider themselves slighted. Bread, too, was a staple. Served with every meal, the palace bakeries made 200 cheat loaves every day, as well as 700 white manchette loaves, which resemble small white rolls and were only for high-ranking members of the court. It was known that water was often a carrier for disease, although the science explaining why was not yet understood. Ale, usually of low alcohol content, was the main drink of the court, but wine was also a popular option, with 300 barrels being consumed each year. Records show that in 1528, Henry spent £844 on barrels of Bordeaux, which in modern money would come to more than £250,000. Although fresh fruit was viewed with suspicion, when cooked and served as a preserve or baked into a pie, it was a popular choice. Henry himself is said to have been partial to marmalade. Any leftovers at the end of a meal were either passed down to those of lower rank or given away to the poor. On a day-to-day basis, the king either took his meals in his own private chambers, or if he was being a little more formal, seated beneath the canopy of state in his presence chamber. His food was prepared in a separate kitchen from that of the rest of the court, and he was also able to choose from a wide variety of dishes. On celebration days or when notable guests were visiting, Henry would dine in public, and the Tudor flair for opulent feasts became evident. Dishes were sometimes served coated in gold or silver leaf, or scented with such exotic fragrances as rosewater, ambergris, or musk. One visitor in 1517 remarked on the 20 different types of jelly that were served in the shape of various castles and animals. Henry is known to have favored jelly flavored with hypocras, a type of sweet and spiced wine. Sweet wafers or biscuits stamped with the royal coat of arms were usually served at the end of a banquet, but only to the king and other high-ranking members of the court. Perhaps the most extravagant part of a Tudor banquet came in the form of the subtleties. These were intricate and colorful sculptures that were made mainly of marzipan and spun sugar, and as such were exorbitantly expensive. These impressive centerpieces took many forms, including that of animals, people, ships, and various mythological scenes. Another creation was the cockatrice, a combination of a pig's head sewn to the rear of a chicken. This would both entertain and feed Henry and his guests, as it did in honor of Francis I at the Field of the Cloth of Gold. Even on days where food intake was supposed to be more frugal, the king was able to dine in style. Fridays, Saturdays, Wednesdays, and the entirety of Lent were decreed by the church to be fast days, where the consumption of meat was not allowed. One fast day menu served to Henry and his queen, Catherine of Aragon, included but wasn't limited to porpoise, seal, salmon, lobsters, haddock, soup, lampreys, custard, and fruit. By contrast, those at the poorer end of society would have had much more limited diets. By the time of Henry VIII's reign, most families would have been able to afford meat, although for the majority, it would usually have been preserved, either smoked or salted. Fresh vegetables, dairy, and rye, or wholemeal bread, were the primary components of most meals. Various theories have been debated by historians regarding Henry and his ultimate demise, and whilst it is unlikely that a definitive diagnosis will ever be determined, it is likely that he was suffering from at least one malady brought about by his poor diet, type 2 diabetes and high blood pressure being the main contenders. What is certain, though, is that Henry's inability to exercise due to a leg injury that never fully healed, combined with his huge caloric intake, meant that the obesity of his later life and the resultant health complications were inevitable. Are you hungry to build a website? Use Wix to easily create the site that you dream of, regardless of your skill level. Go to wix.com/go/simplehistory to create a professional site today. Wix has great features to bring your site to life, such as Wix Videos, Wix Pro Gallery, Wix Bookings, and solutions for all kinds of sites, such as e-commerce, music, hotels, events, restaurants, and more. Build your own website and support the Simple History channel by going to wix.com/go/simplehistory, or simply click the link in the description below.